It's the one, the only, Katey Sagal, everyone.
Hello.
Okay, I have loved you for so long, and I was sitting at my kitchen table trying to eat while reading your book and not being able to swallow because I was so verklempt and like I had cake in my throat. I love your book so much. Oh,
thank you so much. That's so nice.
I mean, this, I have been with this for some time now. And, you know, it's Mother's Day and we're talking about moms. And you just describe being a mother in a way that I don't often read. And I know as mothers, we struggle for the words to describe the indescribable.
Thank you. Well, I was just going to say the book started as prose that I wanted to write for my children, basically. And it was just sort of snippets of my life. And, you know, you sort of get to a place in your life where you're like, oh, I want them always, I want them to remember. I want them to know about me and their lives and where they came from. So it kind of was born out of that. And, you know, lo and behold, it became a book. But it was intended as sort of just for my kids.
It reads very poetically, too. There's,
Oh, thank you.
I know you're a rock and roll musician. Music has been such an integral part of your life, and it has sort of a beatnik, poetic, one-word sentences, and then you go down, and I grew up obsessed with poetry, and I just thought, there are no rules to writing. You actually want your reader to read the way it is in your mind, and you just do such a beautiful job of it.
Thank you so much. It was really a labor of love, and it was one of the hardest things I've ever done.
What I love about your book, and this is the ultimate Mother's Day read, is that we come into this world, you know, with our own history with our moms, and then we're just, as moms, trying to do the best we can, not repeat patterns, break cycles, and just the way that you spoke about your first daughter, your oldest daughter, was something I just hadn't read because I felt so connected to you. I'm so scared of, you know, whatever I'm doing, especially with my firstborn daughter, Olive. There's a different relationship there than there is with Frankie. The love is equal, but the karma is different. And I just hadn't read anyone who kind of had the humor without being best friendy. It was like, you talked about the role reversals you go through as you grow up together.
Yes, we definitely do. And I find that that role reversal has been as enlightening for me as it is for her, as long as I kind of stay in step with it. You know, I think that, you know, I've always been really honest with my children. I have told them things that, you know, so that I always wanted them to feel, and I wanted, and they do, that there's an open door, that they can always talk to me about everything. And, you know, because it's a big, wide, scary world out there sometimes. So you want to be, and this was something I couldn't do with my own parents. I went through a lot of stuff that I just didn't feel safe telling them about. And I never wanted to, and I still don't want to create that non-place for them. I want them to be able to have open conversation. You know, my thing with them is always like, look, if you tell me the truth and it's something that, you know, we don't like, it's better that you tell me the truth. You'll get in less trouble if you tell me the truth. So that's kind of where I come from with it.
I'm so relieved to hear you say that because I say the same things to my kids all the time. And even if it's something I don't like, I will give it time and then circle back to what we need to fix about that. But in that moment, I'm like, let this secret be safe. Let me be a safe place that's not going to respond immediately or judge or punish or anything. I don't want to react. I just want to listen. And then we'll get there. Don't worry. We'll get there.
Yeah.
We're going to deal with this.
We'll get there.
And I'm so glad to hear you say that. And really, this is a book that like needs to be read by mothers. It's no matter what your experience with your own family or what you're going through with your kids, there is honesty, humor, and triumph in your perspective that's very fresh and different than other books I've read.
Wow, Drew, this is so nice to hear you say all this, because I feel good about that book too. It's been out for a couple of years. So thank you. I really, really appreciate that.